What's going on, everybody? We'll be starting here in a minute. Thank you guys for showing up early.
Oh, that was horrible. Have you never said my name out loud before? Manzanilla? No, it's chamomile. I don't think you are, man. I think that was your lack of Mexican showing. Oh, that doesn't sound racist all. I'm all right, you know. Mostly, let's be real though. Mostly I play Fortnite now. Yeah, that's not what I said, but it's cool. It's cool. It's cool that you said that. You know, a game wants to throw a sponsorship my way, I'm gonna play the damn game. You, because you can see your comments, I can't see your comments. Panoramic, that's not what that says, it's Pandorica.
Oh, I forgot to take off my mute button on here. He said they couldn't hear me. Jay, what's up, buddy? All that conversation
It might help
that
you.
you had was talking to yourself.
Yeah, I was talking shit to you. So it might help you to watch my stream on yours because I'm watching yours on mine to keep the comments in line.
Got you. Everybody, let me do my intro again because y'all missed it since I was talking to myself like a bum. I'm Joey, aka J Rent. And then this is Elizabeth. Manzanilla, Manzana,
That's enough.
Mancias, like Carlos Mencius. Just kidding, just kidding, just kidding. And we are talking about her page again. She is a Fortnite player. She's gonna be streaming Warzone soon.
I would have been.
Just kidding, just kidding, just kidding.
Hi, Jay, by the way.
Stephanie said, "This is so weird seeing y'all both." Why is it weird, Stephanie? You've
Seeing
seen
us
it.
both at the same
You
time,
see, yeah, you've
that
seen
would
us
be weird
both at
because
the
like
same
you see us
time.
at the same time in person like all the time.
Yeah. Don't make it weird.
She's gonna make it weird.
You just made it weird, Stephanie. Hey, everybody who's watching, feel free to comment. That way we can talk back with you and stuff. I could be
So we
like,
can talk
that way
back here.
we can give you shout outs and be like, hey, what's up? Shout out to whoever's commenting on here.
Oh.
Just like that.
Shout out to whoever's commenting on here.
Shout out to the next commenter on this post on this stream. All right. Here, I'm gonna go to the big media screen, guys. All right. If you guys haven't added her already, this is her page. Dollface1566 Gaming content creator. As you can see, she's got some videos and stuff. Oh, she's got that one on there for our stream.
Weird. You're weird, Steffi.
What? Hell yeah, we're gonna be talking about episode 5, but we're not there yet. We gotta carry this
Spoiler
conversation
alert.
going. Yeah, we're gonna talk about episode 5 and all the cool things that I saw on TikTok about this.
Well, I would have not seen any of them because I don't TikTok.
I was TikToking all yesterday,
Oh, I
trying to
was
find out
literally
theater,
TikToking. Yep.
TikToking to find out the best theories of what's gonna happen in
Work-related
episode 7. But we gotta stop talking about that. We're not talking about that no more. We're not
TikToking.
talking about that no more. We'll get there. We'll get there. We're trying to see Dollface Gaming's page. Liz, what do you like about streaming as far as your gameplay? What is one of the things you enjoy the
As far
most?
as gameplay is concerned,
Yeah, what do you enjoy?
so I think it's pretty obvious. If anybody has seen me, they know that I'm just like a giant kid. I just want to play games to have fun. I'm not really in search of W's, but if you come at me trying to get a W, we'll get one. But mostly, I just like to troll my friends and make them lose and do things that make me laugh because games are supposed to be fun, right?
So you started off playing retro games, and I used
I
to.
still do. I still try. It's just a lot harder. It's a lot more difficult to pull those off, honestly.
You're actually getting pretty good at Fortnite, aren't you?
Yeah, I'm officially a sponsored Fortnite player.
Sponsored Fortnite player, but you have other sponsors besides Fortnite, don't you? You got like
None of them are video games, though.
Taco
I have
Bell.
a I working on Taco Bell,
Aren't you
actually.
sponsored by Taco Bell?
I wish. I want to be. That'd be a cool sponsorship. Just found that one out yesterday. But I'm sponsored by Best Buy. What is it? Razer computer accessories. I have a list. Where is my list? Best Buy, Razer computer accessories. Of course, Epic and Fortnite. GameStop, GameFly, the game rental company. And then there's a new one that just kind of came out. I don't know if y'all know about this thing. It's called what is it? I'm gonna actually show this to you right now too, because I don't think I've even mentioned this to you because I'm bad at communicating. But I'm gonna send you this link so you can see it. It's
Send me them
called,
links.
yeah, I'll send you them links.
Yeah, send me them
Hopefully there won't
links.
be a big delay on that link sending.
Send me them hot links.
Hot links.
Sausage links. Send me
Sausage?
them
Like sausage
sausage
links?
links.
It's called Skin Wallet.
Daddy's hungry.
Daddy's hungry for sausage though?
Oh, I meant barbecue.
Oh, okay.
So I see you got a tip jar on here from Stream Elements. They can
Yes,
tip. They.
I don't market that as much as I should, but you
How
know, it seems to be
do.
okay.
So when you. Because I'm a gamer myself.
What?
I'm
You
a
play
gamer
games?
myself. And.
What are you in?
that's not what I want to see. Okay. I know that you get, tips from stars, but you also have a tip jar set up, right?
Right, there is a tip jar set up for me.
Okay.
I don't really put that out there that much. I kind of feel like if people are going to throw tips my way, they're going to do it whether or not I ask. Also, I don't like to be beggy. I feel like I don't have to be beggy, right?
No, you don't have to. But if they wanted to tip you, and if they don't know, because I don't know, and whenever I put on your stream and I take a gander, take a peek.
New rock star on YouTube gives the best theories. I'll definitely look into that. I'll let Joey know to look into that too. One of my followers, Gilbert Castano, he said, "New rock star on YouTube gives the best theories."
Rockstar.
New rock
Did he
star.
just call me a rock star?
He did not, I promise.
Whatever. So if they want to tip you on the tip jar, do they
You could
is
just
it on
click
your
the link
comments?
from my
Is
description.
this one right here? Is it this one?
Yeah, it's the link right in the description of every live video I have.
I see it. Oh, okay. So in case like
So if
they
you are in my live video feed and the first comment that posts, my pinned comment, it'll be right in that comment.
Nice. So if they miss your stream but like your video post, they can go here and be like, "Oh man, I missed that stream. I didn't get her give her these sexy stars." They can go
These
here.
sexy stars.
These I wasn't able to give her these stars, and then they can just go right here and tip you anyway after the
Right,
fact.
or on my actual Facebook page, it is in my about info.
I see. Okay.
Yeah,
Okay.
I'm all set up. I don't put it out there like I should, I feel like.
How do you and I'm trying to get pointers for me. This is not even for the guys on the chat. This is all for me now. How do you set up for these sponsorships? Do you apply for them? Is it something that anybody can do or?
So a lot of them were not applications. A few of the companies I did somewhat apply to, like with Razer, that affiliacy and sponsorship came from me becoming a Razer streamer first. And I really just wanted to be a Razer streamer because I wanted to have a brand to show that I was serious and not just here to fuck around and show my titties like a lot of girls do.
Whoa.
I ain't here for that.
Titties.
But yeah, no, I'm not here to show my titties.
Okay.
But that was part of the reason why Razer accepted me into their Razer streamer group. And from there, the marketing team reached out to me about affiliacy, which means I use a lot of Razer products. So as long as I let everybody know what I'm using, which I do in every video, every description on every video shows all the products I use. That's where that partnership came from. So it just came from me reaching out to them about being a Razer streamer, and then they came back to me about being a partner with them.
They
With
were
a lot of the
like,
other companies,
we can't see your tits. You're hired. No, just
maybe,
kidding.
you never know. A lot of companies don't want to back that kind of gamer girl image. They
Hey,
don't
you
want
know
that on
what?
their end.
That's awesome. I think anybody who can get a sponsorship without having to sell their what is it? Sexuality?
Yeah,
What?
that's something I never wanted to do. I wanted to be here to play games and entertain. I'm not here to show y'all the goods.
I'm just gonna show
Because
my
if I did, I
sexy
better be making a
ass.
lot more money than I am. Damn.
I believe that. I believe that.
But
There's a page that I've heard about and I've never seen it. It's called Only Fanboys, Only Fans, or something like
oh,
that.
you've never seen it.
I've
Although I do have a friend who's a DJ who does follow my page, so if you're watching, let me know about it. Tell your mom I said hi to you, Stephanie. He is a DJ, and he's thought about putting his DJing on OnlyFans because they're trying to branch out of the sex market.
What?
Yeah, they're trying to become a streaming platform. They've actually mastered streaming, if I'm going to be honest. They've made live streaming capable in everybody's household, no matter your internet connection or your equipment. So they're trying to reach out to other people like DJs and artists, people who do live art. Crazy, crazy, crazy reach out.
Guys, you're gonna be able to find me here on Facebook, and if you can't, you can always visit my OnlyFans
I would not
subscription
go. I said it.
charges.
I couldn't ever put that in my description because everybody would go there expecting the worst.
I know that would be interesting.
I mean, the best for them, the
Podcasts on
worst for me.
OnlyFans.
That doesn't sound right.
Yeah, that would be a little weird. I would really trick some people, I think. They'd be like, "What?"
I wouldn't be able to market with a lot of the brands that do back me, actually. They would drop me in a heartbeat.
I would probably have no subscribers. I'd probably have
Did
to
you check
sh
out that skin wallet link I sent you?
No, because I don't want to click on it. If I click on it, I'm afraid I'm gonna mess up this
Oh,
whole
well,
setup
okay, so
and bring down.
Skinwallet is a new company. It's just starting up. If you have skins that you've purchased from CSGO,
Skid what?
Skin Wallet.
Skid wall.
Skin Wallet. You know what I'm saying.
I can go here and make sure my Pornhub doesn't show on the search bar here. That would
I just wanted to see
really
it on
be
my
a
computer. That would be a really bad
that
choice.
would be really embarrassing.
So CSGO, if you have any inventory on CSGO, which is where you would upload your skins or buy independent skins for games like Fortnite and Call of Duty and stuff like that, if you want to resell the skins that you've purchased, you can actually set up an account with Skin Wallet and you can sell them on the market. You can sell back your skins or you can
Is
buy skins from other people at a discount.
this an NFT?
It is a startup NFT, yeah.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah,
So,
they reached out to me about 2 weeks ago. I just signed contracts with them and stuff. They're just trying to get their name out there.
this is whole like you can buy it with crypto. Because in order to buy something like this, you need to spend Ethereum, right? I don't want to talk about
It
crypto.
has to be in the e-wallet. It's any e-wallet they've managed to make it, which is really cool of them.
This is pretty cool. Yeah,
Yeah, that's a brand new one for me. I'm still looking into it because
so
I don't know much about it yet. I don't have any skins I'd be willing to throw on the market yet because I'm still attached to them all. But the moment I do, I'm definitely going to check it out to see how it works so I can let y'all know exactly how it works.
hell yeah. That's actually really cool. I like that idea that like if you buy something in the game for 10 bucks and you want to sell it, you can resell it for 10 bucks. I'm assuming to somebody else, like another player
Yeah, it's
or
like a resale site, just like as if you were doing consignment clothing or things like that.
that's fucking badass, dude.
And it's cool that they kind of reached out to me because you brought it up to me not long ago that it would be a really cool idea, right?
Yeah, I
And
came
then
up
pretty
with
much
it.
a couple of days later, they reached out to me via email.
Yeah, I
They
came up
got
with that
my
idea.
contact from Twitch, not Facebook, which is strange because my Twitch following isn't that great.
What's going on here? Is everybody watching your stream and not mine? Because no one's saying anything to me. Hell no.
There's not a lot of comment going on in my feed.
Hell
There are
no.
more people watching your stream than there are watching mine. There are five on you and three on me.
Beep, 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 beep. I'm just kidding.
But if you are watching my stream and you don't already follow JRent2000, go ahead and throw him a follow. I will actually link his page in my description for the video.
Hell yeah. Hell yeah, guys. Let me see. I have a few more questions for you. How long have you been a content creator?
So in the most recent period, I just really started this actively back in January. Before that, I did it for a few years, well, maybe a year and a half to 2 years on Mixer. But that was a long, long time ago. And then I kind of fell off Mixer. Mixer disappeared, got bought by Facebook, and I lost the motivation. I won't lie, that's hard to start over from scratch. And it wasn't until pretty recently where, between you pushing me and friends and other ex co-streamers pushing me to jump on Facebook, even though it's a difficult market, but I'm really glad all y'all did because it's
I
starting to
told you.
grow and be
I
really
told you.
successful. To be fair, you said if you can really do it, you should. And I kind of did it
Stay
initially
to
spitefully to be like, I
Twitch.
can really do this.
You just gotta believe in yourself.
Well, I mean, I believe in myself, but I needed you to believe in me too.
Believe in the Almighty Father, Odin.
Oh, so speaking of which, segue, segue, segue. That's ugly. You're so
No,
No, I'm just trying to get away from the conflict conversation.
oh no, yeah. You know, I'm just playing. I'm just teasing you. I just gotta, you know, tease you with a.
You gotta throw that in there every now and then.
Yeah. Now you also have a Twitch account as well
I do
that
have a
they
Twitch
people
account
can
and
follow
under the
you
same
at.
name.
That people can follow you at. Send me that link. Send me the hot link.
I'll get it up for you right now.
That way, guys, you can add her Twitch if you have Twitch. You know, following is free. You know, tune in once in a while on Twitch as well as Facebook. Same for me. Same for me. JRent2000 on Twitch. Follow me on Twitch. J-Run
Oh, that
2000.
was creepy the way you're saying that.
J-Run 2000, follow me on Twitch.
Oh, whispering it makes it better. You're right. There you go. I sent you that link.
Right. That's we'll get that one pulled up here so people can see that. Copy.
ASMR. No.
What?
Cardi Joey. Cardi Joey. That's heartbreaking. No naked taping? Oh, yeah, not today. Not today. Not ever. Hopefully. I have daughters. Don't need them ever having that come back around to them.
I see you
Oh,
got
wow.
so
My
many.
page is pink, pink. You have a lot of windows open, sir. It's all that
We're
junk.
gonna. What you gonna do with all that junk? All my windows. I'm gonna click, close them out. Oh no, I gotta pause
Oh.
this. I don't wanna hear your audio. But look, alright, guys, check it out. This is her Twitch page right here.
My Twitch isn't that live and popping, which is says a lot. A
Wait.
lot of people are like really, whenever they come to me about questions about how to like become successful as a content creator, their biggest concern is they're gonna start from nothing. But like, I legitimately started with zero here on Facebook and Twitch at the beginning of the year. It's just about how much you want to grind and how much drive you have. Because my Twitch is still growing. My
It's
Facebook's popping, but my Twitch is still growing.
day-to-day grinding.
Yeah. You gotta commit, fully commit to it.
So on Twitch, it's Dollface1566. Be sure to add her on there so that way you can check her out. And every time that I tune into her, she's always talking with everybody. She's probably doing that 50% at the time of the game.
The other 50% I devoted to dying.
And dancing. I've seen you dance.
I like to dance on people I'd kill. It's a learned trade.
there's nothing wrong with that. Those are pretty funny things to do.
Like I said, I'm not the best Fortnite player. The fact that Fortnite reached out to me and like offered sponsorship at all was crazy. But I am entertaining. I do have a following for it because I know that I'm silly and people like to tune and watch the funny.
You are a good content creator. People like talking to you. You're funny. You're very nice, and that's why
I'm
people
not
show
bad
you
at the game
support.
either, though, to be fair.
What you said.
I'm not bad. I'm not bad.
What you said. Exactly. You're
I beat a couple 9-year-olds.
you know, I've seen you play. You do very well. So, you know, what is that word? Kudos? Cooties to you. Cooties to you.
Oh, not
Like I'm
cooties.
saying. All right. So, I think I've asked you just about enough questions for me. That way, I took all my notes down so I can, you know, improve my
You've answered
page.
pretty much all the I've answered pretty much all the questions that get commonly asked, yeah.
Okay. Do you have anything else that you want to throw out there about your page before we move on to the next hot topic? Can I say that? Hot topic? Oh, I can
Okay,
say that.
Wendy Williams.
So, like, even though that's the name of a store, can you get sued for
Yeah, I
copyright?
don't think it's the same.
Oh.
No, I mean, I guess if you don't follow me, go ahead and throw me a follow. I stream every day now, sometimes 2 or 3 times a day. And if you do play Fortnite, you can jump on with me. I always accept follower requests and I will play games with my followers whenever. If I'm online, I'm always willing to open up my party to followers or strangers as long as they're not going to make me carry them because I can't.
Plus, you share people's content. I noticed that
Yes.
a lot of followers that you have are content creators as well that have their own
Or they're
pages.
just really great players, honestly. If you have content that you want to send my way for me to post on my page, you don't have to do any editing. Just send me the raw video and I'll get that up there. I'll get that out there for you.
Yep, same. You know what? I'm gonna send you all my clips because I
I'm
am
not going to post a
so
single one.
lazy that I editing. Here, I'm gonna send
I'm
you
just
some
kidding.
clips. I got about 40 videos. If you could take care of me,
Oh,
that'd be great.
Totally. I have all the time for that.
All right, we are gonna move into our next topic now. So, thank you for telling us everything about your page, and you know, I'm glad we got everybody to get to know you. We're gonna talk about Lo not Loki yet, the fifth episode, but we're gonna talk about American Gods, which kind of You mentioned ties a little bit, has some connection, not necessarily to that show,
It's
direct
not a
connection.
direct connection, but it's a pretty cool
Yeah,
little
yeah, yeah.
intrigue.
If you like Greek, or I'm sorry, not even Greek
Pop and
mythology.
foods, you're right.
What is
Yeah.
it? Norse mythology?
Norse mythology, yeah.
Is that like
Nordic.
Nordic? Guys, there's a show called American Gods. It's been out for a while already. If you haven't seen it, you're probably not gonna pay to see it, and you probably won't see it. But if you do decide to pay and see
If you
it,
have Prime or if you have Showtime.
Prime or Showtime, American Gods. You won't be disappointed. It doesn't really drag, but there are some really good episodes, and it gives you just enough to keep on coming back and
If you're into
watch.
mythology, if you're into action, if you're into adventure, it kind of touches on every like interest.
What's going on, Andrea? How you been? She said, "I'm a Loki."
You're definitely a Loki.
I was a Loki at one point in my life.
Has that point ended?
I am not a Loki anymore. I am more like a who's fierce and scary. That's who I'm like. I'm scary now. What god is that?
Oh,
I'm like
yeah.
a badass god of war now. I'm like Odin
You're
now.
totes fierce and scary.
Oh
Oh, I
yeah.
can see that you're playing my lobby in the background there. Me
Your
and my
lobby.
Fortnite friends douching around in the lobby. You didn't exit the Dollface Facebook page.
I'll exit out for you.
For me, thanks. Mostly, I didn't think that anybody wanted to hear that donkey noise going on in
Just
the background.
for you. No, you can't hear the noise. You can't hear any of that noise. All you
Don't know
can
what.
hear is my sweet voice and yours. Yes, episode 5 was on point. We're gonna talk about it. I got
Doesn't
some.
this mean okay?
It means on point. Like it was A-okay.
I mean, if somebody says something's okay to me, I feel like, it's just okay.
If I
I'm
do
just kidding.
this,
I'm just fussing. I'm just fussing.
this is how I would use this right here. I'd be like, "Man, did you see episode 5, bro?" That's what I would do. I would be like,
You still have this plane. It's okay.
"Have what plane?" No, I don't have anything planned.
No.
All
Good, good.
right, we're talking about American Gods now. Okay, we've seen our me and you have actually seen already all 3 seasons that are
Oh,
there.
yes. How did
So
we do that?
we're gonna go through every single episode with you. Just kidding.
Starting with episode one. All right. Episode one, season one. Wait, wasn't there like five pilots for this show?
There was who?
Five pilots.
Five pilots. No, it's about gods, not
Good.
pilots.
Oh, yeah. Okay. I'm over this. I'll see y'all later.
Look, guys, I'm gonna show y'all a trailer of American Gods. It's really cool. I'm gonna probably play just this much of audio because I don't want it to mute it out anyway when it goes posted on Facebook. So I'm gonna this much. Okay. Ow, that hurts. Okay. All right. So I'm gonna play it. I want y'all to check it out. This is just the opening scene of it. Check it out though. It's probably gonna play an ad because I've had it here for so long. Oh shit.
Oh shit.
Oh shit, it just got real. All right, I'm gonna mute it now. I have to mute it because, like I said, I don't want it to block my video. But this is the opening scene of it. And it gives you all these like cool depictions of like these gods and then pills.
What is it that you're always gasping about? Oh, the visuals, the visuals.
Visuals are outstanding in this movie or show, I'm sorry, not movie. I mean just they're sexy. Just look at the colors. Whoever came up with this opening.
Just so y'all know, he's talking about this show in a brighter light than he talks about me. That's so cool.
Look at this. Right, now I gotta stop it there because I don't want to get sued. or copyright.
Don't want to get sued.
Boom. American Gods. All right, there's a pause button. Getting confused on my computer. My computer. Watch this show if you got nothing else to do.
I mean, even if you got other shit to do, the show is
If
worth
you're
it for sure.
with your girlfriend and you finish watching everything there is to watch, put this on. If you're with your boyfriend and you want him to see something cool that you think he'll like this. He'll be like, "Babe, I don't want to see that bullshit." And then you get him watching this, and he'll be like, "Wait, baby, don't turn it off. Let's watch another episode. Watch. Bet. Bet.
Bet.
Big bet."
Big bet.
American Gods is on Prime.
It's a
Yes.
Showtime add-on.
What she said, Showtime add-on. Now, without giving away too much, if you haven't seen it, it talks about old gods and it talks about new gods. Now, I'll give away some spoilers without giving away everything. The new gods, the American gods, are things that people worship. So, like, one of the gods in the show is called the Media God. What's her name? New Media? No,
No,
that's.
it's New Media, second
No.
half of the series.
Okay, so media, the god of media. So you know how everybody watches TV and
Newspaper, radio.
newspaper, radio. There's a god, and it's because since people are always like, watching those things, that's how she was created. So she's considered a new god, as opposed to the old gods, like I would say Jesus, which I don't want to say that this has him in here, but which he
It
might.
has
He might,
a
and he
lot
may
of
not be the
Jesus in
Jesus
the
that
show,
you think.
technically. A lot of Jesus.
But American Gods is really about how what would you say it's about? It's about Shadow Moon. Shadow Moon is the what is it, the protagonist?
He is the protagonist, yes.
Shadow Moon is a protagonist in this show. And he's just your average guy, and he happens to meet this gentleman who is a god, pretty much. And you get the idea that he's a god throughout the show. They just don't tell you who he is. You won't know who he is, and we're not gonna tell you who he is. You have to find out who he is. They keep you guessing, like, who the fuck is this guy? but he goes through a series of events following this guy to talk about to gather up the old gods. So that way they can start a war against the new gods. And during that process, you meet all these old gods in the process and you're like, oh, I know who that is. Just from the course of like
Or you just end up on Google a lot.
the Google, what? The
You
who?
end up on the Google a lot.
You end up on Google a lot because you're trying to figure shit out. You're like, what's going on here? So you start Googling
It's
whatever that
so
is.
addictive. It wraps you up entirely.
Right. So, all of season one is about starting the journey. Season two is more so finding out who everybody is and kind of what their place is. Everybody except the protagonist's place. You still don't know what his purpose is. He has a purpose, and you don't know what it is. You won't know his purpose until season three. So once you get to season three, you're gonna be like, damn, that's wild. Damn, that's wild. I did not see that coming. But then when it happens, you're like, oh, I guess I could have saw it. Yeah, that makes sense. So just believe in
The
whatever
buildup
you
is a lot more intense than the reality. Yep.
believe whatever you think is right. Damn, I want to give away spoilers to the show, Liz.
I mean, the show's been out for a hot minute.
Hot minute.
I don't know if the spoilers would really be that drastic for this show.
You know what, guys? If you don't want to hear the spoilers,
Put us on mute. Don't stop watching. Just mute
actually,
it.
yeah, no, actually, go ahead. I don't care. Anyway, okay, so I read on the end of the season three. Do you know who Mr. World is, right?
And now I do, yeah.
Who is he?
He is Loki.
Yes, he is. He's Loki.
And in
He's
just a few
Loki.
episodes before they reveal that, they talk about how they banished him.
Loki is in American Gods, guys. You get to see Loki, more Loki, but he's a much cooler Loki in this one. This one, he's more like
He's
sinister.
intense.
Oh yeah, he's awesome.
If y'all remember Charlie's Angels and that guy who smelled their hair after he cut it off, that's the guy who plays him primarily, and he's fucking great as an actor in general. Mr. Worldwide.
Mr. Worldwide. God dang it. Mr. Worldwide. Oh, that's not it either. Who the hell?
What are you doing over here? Do I need to send you links again?
No, I want people to see who the actor is who plays Mr. World.
It's like I just said, do I have to send you links again?
Oh my God, what is going on?
You're not very bright sometimes.
American. You know what? I can type about 10 words per minute.
Wow.
So
That's really good.
this guy right here is an
Check your
American
links.
Gods.
Check your links.
Right here. This guy right here is
Or ignore me. What is?
weird. My links, my hot links. Yeah, Crispin Glover. There you go.
That's a good link to show, is what I'm saying.
Chris Lee. That's right, sir. You are 100% correct. So I think he's a really cool character. You see him all
He's
through
a
the
great
seasons.
actor to
He's a
begin
great
with.
actor. Anyway, Mr. World, he's Loki. I'm just kidding.
I love him too, Stephanie.
You kind of find out who it is. Actually, they don't even tell you who it is, but pretty sure that's who it is. So watch this show. You won't regret it. And he basically fights against all these other guys and stuff like that. Blah, 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 blah. All right. Here we go. Do you have anything to add? Hello, McFly.
Yeah, that's exactly where I thought of him first from too.
You get your hands off her, Biff. I say that all the time.
In general about American Gods or about Mr. World specifically?
Yeah, what do you like about American Gods? Is it the sex scenes?
Absolutely not. You know I hate that in regular television. If I want to watch porn, I'm going to go to Pornhub.
They show a lot of boobies in American
There
Gods.
is a lot of boobs, vaginas, titties, and a lot of penises.
They do show peepees. They show a few peepees in
And
there.
the gay sex scenes are a lot.
Yeah, that's a little weird parts for me when they come up. I'm like,
Yeah, he says that, but then, like, if I get in his way, he's like, move out of my way. Trying to watch the show.
gay sex, get out of my way. What's gonna happen next?
I don't know how this works.
Yeah, there's,
Let me straighten
well,
that
you
up
know
for you.
what? I like the nicknames, like cunt wife.
Cunt wife.
Your friend gave me those eyes, those suspect eyes.
Which friend?
Because you said that I told you to move out of the way whenever the
Oh,
gay
well, I
scenes
mean,
come up.
didn't you?
Not because of that. You don't know what's gonna happen. They don't show no penetration. It's not real gay sex.
Well, sort of. There's that like one thing with what was it?
They did. Now they did have them on like this.
With like the fire going inside of him and stuff. That was an interesting
They
little
had him like
snip.
this, and he was like,
Oh,
let me throw your legs above your shoulder. And I was just,
so they like did a silhouette sex scene for the gay sex scene to make it entirely too vivid.
that was too much, man. Big old manly feet just fucking
And if anybody was
legs
wondering
up
what I'm talking about, I will gladly
to
send you links to it because that stuff was great. That was gold. That was Showtime gold.
Yeah, there's a. It doesn't happen a lot. I think it only happened like twice. Yeah, it only happened twice in like once in the first season, and then once in the third season. So, don't worry, it's not filled with it.
No, it's really not.
It's actually pretty funny. They joke about it in a way that doesn't get them in trouble, I think, or that would cause any backlash. Because they make fun of it. They make fun of gay stuff, but then they make it okay, like that, you know, the being gay is okay, which it is totally okay. But they make fun of it first, and then they go and they're like, eh. So you're making fun of it? You know, they correct themselves on show. Like, you can't get mad at them.
Don't rewind the scenes, right? I don't know. I don't know if he had the controller, maybe.
Rewind the scene? Oh,
He said, "Don't
hell
rewind
no.
them."
Hell no. Now, there's some really good scenes in that show. Good
Yeah.
visuals. Good visuals. You know? And if you like imagery, that's the word that I use. The imagery is beautiful. It's
The
beautiful.
color schemes and the
The
backstories,
colors.
everything just makes a lot of sense, and they
Yeah.
make the imagery really, really, really spot on.
Yes. All of this is true. So this is really cool. It's a show about gods. And I think now that we've mentioned, you know, that this show's being about gods, we can move on to Loki. I think I'm ready to move on to Loki. I don't know about you. Do you have anything else besides the gay
What's
sex
Loki?
from American Gods?
I'm sorry, what's Loki?
What's Loki? Loki is a god. He's this
Who's
TV show.
Loki?
Loki's
Reminds
a
me of
TV show.
Spartacus. Oh, you know, I never saw Spartacus, but I did have friends tell me about Spartacus. It's not as intense as what my friends described Spartacus being. It was literally two scenes on two episodes. It
Didn't
wasn't that bad.
Spartacus, the one who got his heels cut and he couldn't run?
Achilles?
No, Spartacus.
Achilles.
Why do you keep saying Achilles? I said Spartacus.
Do you know where your Achilles tendon is?
Yes, that's what I said.
Isn't that the one that gets cut?
Yes, that's the one he got cut. Spartacus' Achilles got cut.
I hate you. I hate
I'm
you.
just
We have
kidding.
no understanding with each other.
I'm just kidding. Everybody knows Spartacus is the one who can. He had that Disney movie.
Oh.
He's the one with the Disney movie.
What Disney movie?
The one that cartoon.
Hercules? Just kidding.
Yeah,
Just kidding again.
that one. Yes, that one.
Right,
Right.
that's enough with the
Yeah,
jokey
we're done. All right. See, episode 5 of Loki.
jokies.
Guys, come back,
You should see
everybody.
how Chris is reacting in my comment feed right now. He's like showing you the that's stupid, like, the fuck face.
He likes my facial expressions.
No, that's the face he's giving you about your answers right now.
He's all, he doesn't really know much, does he?
It's worth a Google. You
You
have a
know
computer
what?
in front of
I learn things as I go.
you. Do you now?
I learn stuff just right this instant. Don't want to talk about this no more. Let's move on to Loki 5. Loki number 5. Does it sound like a dance song?
Like Mambo number five.
No, Loki number 5. A little bit of Loka. Loka? Loki by my side. A little bit of Thor is all I need. Da,
A
da. All right,
little bit of Thor is all you need.
what did you think about episode 5?
So they mastered the cliffhanger. I'm just going to throw that out there. They have the cliffhanger down to a goddamn science.
Oh yeah, and
So, like, we were anticipating episode five since the end of episode four.
yes. I
It
really
did not
like
disappoint.
the explanation for the void at the end. Like, the end is still being formed, but they're in that place that, you know, that never gets finished as it goes. What did you think about all the Lokis that they met? What did you think about Alligator Loki?
Well, if you haven't seen it yet,
That's a
not
spoiler.
that important, honestly.
Oops. Spoiler alert. There's an
Alligator Loki is a
alligator
thing.
looking. Yeah, and he talks, and apparently you can understand him.
Well, I don't know if he talks. He laughs.
What did you think about Kid Loki?
Kid Loki was interesting. Kid Loki was an intense character that I wish they would have developed more on.
Oh, he hasn't saw it yet. What's up, drunk wizard? What's going on, buddy? How you doing?
Hello.
He's saying hi to me, not you.
I'm also saying hello to him.
He said he hasn't seen it, and he said that he's being a drunk wizard right now.
Oh, he is commonly, though, so.
The drunk wizard does not disappoint. Thank you, sir, for tuning in to us. And what is up to you? I'm sorry, man. We're talking about Loki episode 5. If you haven't seen it, I apologize. We are going to
The
be talking
description
about
very
it.
clearly said there was going to be
There is
spoilers.
spoilers, yes. So there's kid. We meet Kid Loki. We meet Alligator Loki. We meet Classic Loki, which probably is my favorite out of all of those. And then, no, you know what? I changed my mind. We met President Loki. President Loki. President, yeah, the one that had the button
Oh,
on him.
yeah.
That was, I
President
looked it
Loki.
up. It's President Loki. I like how my favorite part of that whole scene was where like he betrayed the, is it Black Loki? What's that one's name?
Oh God, I don't know what his name is, and I don't want to make any kind of.
I don't know. They didn't give him a name. Yeah, like they said Kid Loki, Classic Loki, but they didn't say
Yeah, they
anything.
definitely did not give him a name, and I think it was out of making sure they didn't cross any boundaries.
I'm sorry, guys. I only know it as Black Loki, but they didn't give him a name. They didn't say like, old man Loki or anything like that. I was Loki and he was black. Okay, I'm just
Yeah,
saying
that's
what
going
I
to be
saw.
his name from a non-racist place.
Yes. It's, by the way, he was very cool looking, I might add. Okay.
His shielding was definitely the coolest there. Let's make this about the cool parts of him.
My favorite part in that scene was when he betrays Kid Loki, and then he was like, "Now I'm the ruler." The agreement was for that, and then that Loki backstabs
Oh,
out.
yeah.
He's like,
That was a
"God
great
dang
part of the
it!"
episode, actually.
The classic Loki goes, "God dang it, we're always backstabbing each other." So all the Loki, and then the president Loki, his guys betrayed him, so nobody nobody could not backstab each other. I thought that was pretty hilarious in the writing of that. Everybody just started fighting and turning on each other. It's kind of funny when he bit off his hand too. I like his late reaction to
You know,
that.
it's funny because you mentioned things and I like don't immediately remember them, honestly. And
Lionel!
there's so much going on in these shows that like it's so easy to not miss it, but overlook it, I guess.
Yeah. Oh yeah, for sure. There was some Easter eggs. Remember I told you about that helicopter that we saw?
Helichopter, yeah, the helichopter.
Hey, look, there's Alligator looking. The best, probably the best one.
Alligator Loki, he's green. He must be Loki, right?
Yeah, that was funny. How do you know he's even a Loki? Well, he's green. You know what? You're right. Look, this one right here. See this one? The helicopter that's at Thanos? That's a homage to the comic books.
Homage? Did you just pronounce that H?
Homage. Isn't that how you say it?
Yeah, it's totally. You got it.
Oh, my buddy said he had to hop off because he hasn't seen it yet.
Oh, just mute us. Keep watching us. We're pretty.
I'm going to send him a personal message. Thanks for. I'm going to spell it like the number 4. Stopping by. And I'm going to spell it like you're saying goodbye. He's going to be
Goodbye.
like, what the hell? Doesn't he have spell check?
No, even if he did, it wouldn't help.
Even if he did, it wouldn't help. Oh, he's hungry? He bite his hand. Yum, sounds fun.
Yum, sounds fun. You say the strangest things.
Drunk Wizard Gaming, you so crazy. Oh, I got this cool theory that I was waiting.
Building myself.
I was waiting for this podcast to talk about it. So you know, what's this dude's name? This guy here.
What's this dude?
This cool dude right here. Remember this guy? So, do you remember
This guy
how,
you can barely see here because the screen is so dark.
I'm gonna cut to the big screen, guys. The big screen.
Thank you.
So, I saw a theory that you remember when he talks about that he makes projections, like really powerful projections. And he made a projection too when all the Lokis were fighting. Do you remember seeing that part? There's a
Yes.
projection of him fighting, and then he mentions
He
about
projected
the
himself.
right. So I saw a really awesome theory that it talks about Kang the Conqueror and who they might see in the building that the chick Loki and regular Loki are going to. And by the way, side note, I think they're going to like hook up or something. I think that's
Hey, I
part of
just
it.
oh, before I forget too, if y'all don't know this yet, technically it's since there's a female Loki is now Disney princess.
That's funny. Yeah, but the girl version, not the
She's a
guy.
Disney princess now.
The girl version, Loki.
The girl version of Loki is a Disney princess now.
The girl version of Loki.
Right,
So,
she's a
hey,
Disney princess.
you're gonna make me forget about this, and I have it in
Right,
my I
probably. You're
have it in my
probably
head.
entirely right.
You
You
know
got
I
this. I believe in you.
you know I can't concentrate and focus.
I believe in you.
Okay. So the cool theory that I saw is this guy is actually the bad guy right here. This guy's actually the bad guy. So his projection, this whole thing about when he was making all those fake Asgard and all that stuff, he's actually the projection, and they're going to meet him in the building. He's the actual bad guy, and they're gonna freak out when they see him. They're gonna be like, "What?" He's the one who probably created the TVA. Loki is the mastermind of the TVA.
That's an interesting theory.
So yeah, when they go, they're actually going to meet Loki, and they're gonna find out that he's the one himself. He's the one in charge of the TVA. How?
And that would be why all the Lokis are hunted. I mean, that would make sense, but why'd you choose him specifically?
What do you mean, him? This guy right here?
Yeah. Is it just because he can project?
Because he's the oldest one out of all of them. He met Thanos first. Yep. Oh yeah, Joel, that's right. So that's what I'm saying. He made a projection of himself, and he was able to fool Thanos. So, and the theory is that he is the one that made all this, and he even mentions too that he went in hiding. Do you remember that he lived by himself in solitude?
On that planet by himself.
Right. So that he might have been giving away some of his stuff, but they were also saying that Kane, there's not enough. Since there's the last, since it's the last episode, there won't be no backstory for Kane the Conqueror. There's nothing to tell you about him that everybody's assuming because of the comics, that he's the bad guy in this show. So I think it's a very good theory, and I wouldn't be surprised if it turns out that he's the one. Loki is the one that is doing it.
Yeah, it's
Be
not a
good.
bad theory.
No. What do you think? What do you think?
Okay, so I'm trying not to think about it. I'm trying my hardest not to think about it.
Why? It's fun.
Because, I mean, for one, every now and then, do you ever just get it completely right? And then you're kind of just like, well, I ruined it for myself. Like the excitement wasn't there. But
Nope.
then other times, do you ever just feel like you have it so right? And whatever you find out what it really is, you're just like, oh, well. It would have made so much more sense if it ended my way. Maybe that's just me.
Yeah, never. I always like knowing, like, damn, that was right. I like guessing right. Isn't that so? Like, you feel good. You're like, fuck yeah, I'm smart. Hell yeah, I knew that was gonna happen.
Fuck yeah, I'm smart. Fuck yeah, I'm smart.
And Joe said, I think Joey is
I
full of
see it.
shit.
I think he might be right. He brings up a good point.
Do you know what, Joelle? I probably am. But we're friends and you tolerate me and I tolerate you.
Do
So,
y'all?
yeah, I tolerate Joelle. Every time you send me a message and I look at it, I'm like,
Damn, I'm tolerating you right now.
oh, you stupid son of a bitch. And then I just text back something else instead of saying that.
Well, you heard it here first, Joel.
I'll be like, "You, Joel, you dumb son of a bitch," and I'll be like, "Oh, that's a cool idea, Joel. Thanks." Damn, you said we weren't friends? Yeah, we are. Shut your mouth. We're friends.
Are me and you friends, Joel? Or am I also mistaken?
Damn, he threw me the finger too.
I'm gonna turn off my camera real quick because I'm gonna turn on this fan and I don't need nobody seeing the awkwardness of my short ass trying to turn it on.
I'm going to pull up another person in the episode 5 that was a cool theory.
Being short is awesome. Can you hear my fan on feedback? I just want to make sure that's not an issue.
Who?
My fan, I just turned it on. And before I sit back down, can you hear it on feedback? Are we sure?
Can't hear
We're not sure. Okay. I'll turn
it.
my camera back on in just a second.
Damn, he get hey, Joel just gave you a nice little finger mabob. Also, he said doll face too. Yeah, he gave us the middle finger. You
Fuck
better.
me and fuck Joey. So that's both straight and gay.
Oh, Joel, yeah. He goes both ways.
I wouldn't doubt it, honestly, with the modern way for sexuality to work.
He always wants to hang out with me, Joel. I told him we can hang out. He just can't grab my butt.
Well, that's stupid because you got a donk. Daddy got a dump truck.
Daddy got a dump truck. Hey,
Daddy got a dump truck.
so another theory I saw about
This
King
doesn't have
the.
anything to do with dump trucks. I'm gonna be real upset.
It's about Loki, okay? Because we're talking about Loki. This isn't topic Joelle.
Oh, I thought we were talking about dump trucks.
What you gonna do with all this donk? So, do you remember this guy right here, this goofy looking dude? And I'm not talking about
Yes.
Joelle, I'm talking about this one here on my
Yes,
screen.
that guy who was super confused and lost the entire time.
Okay, so this guy's name is Casey, right? And when you say it, it's the letter K and the letter C. Casey. So someone came up with a theory that this is actually Kane, K. See, Kane the Conqueror, but it's a variant of Kane the Conqueror.
Well, I
and he's
mean,
working in the
we find
TVA.
out. If you're caught up with the series, you already know they're all variants, so
I thought
we're
that
not
was
spoiling that.
yes. Yeah, but they're saying that KC, meaning his name is actually Kane the Conqueror. I thought that was actually pretty good. That was smart. Whoever thought about that one was
Thought
on
too much
point.
about it.
They were like, "What kind of stuff can I come up with that's gonna blow people away and have them talking about it?" And this was one of them. So I thought that was pretty good. What if he is Kane the Conqueror, like a variant in the show? That'd be pretty neat. And he's got all the
It
Infinity
sucks though, because
Stones.
there's only one more episode, and there's going to be so many unanswered questions, so many unresolved theories.
Joel said my dump truck drags on the floor because I'm so short. Joel, I think I'm taller than you. Okay?
I think therefore I am.
I'm 5'7".
How tall
Five
are you, Joelle?
5'8" with the right pair of boots.
With you have boots?
No.
Well,
But if I had boots, I'd be 5'8".
oh.
I'm a solid 5'7". Solid.
Oh.
Right? Right?
I'm trying to pull this up again so I can see the question. I'm constantly looking.
Joelle says, I think the final villain will be either Kane or someone we haven't guessed. Nah, bro. It ain't gonna be someone we haven't guessed.
I like that answer right there. I like that answer. It's like the safest answer you could possibly make. It'll be this person
It'll be
or
the
it'll
safest
be
person.
anybody else.
It'll be the safest person to guess, or I don't know. That's what you should have said.
Or anybody.
Yeah, bro, you have to make a guess. You can't just say someone we have a guess.
That was safe as fuck.
Mr. 5 foot nothing. Woo! Lino 6'2" in the house. Tallest Mexican I know.
Man, that's an entire, that's more than a foot taller than me right there.
Dude, you are the tallest Mexican I know at 6'2". I don't know anybody else taller than you.
You don't know another person taller than him?
I don't know anybody taller than 6'2". Except
Is
David
that true?
Robinson, and I don't know him, really.
Oh, well, then
I saw him at a
I'm a
Subway
little witty of
once.
what you just said now.
I saw
Oh.
David Robinson at a Subway once, and he was like, and then I was like, was very
That
exciting.
was a great story.
That And then he tips his hat like this.
Like Mr. World.
And who do you think that guy was?
Nobody say it. Nobody say it in the comments. Do not encourage this man.
He said he's a solid 3-1. You stupid son of a bitch. The solid three? I get it. I read it and I already knew what you were talking about.
I don't get it.
Oh, Liz, you commented as me.
I'm fixing it.
You just said I was 4'11 in the
I'm
comments.
fixing it. Y'all don't know me.
Where's Lino at? Lino, are you still there, buddy? Have you seen the latest episode?
Come back for interaction, Lionel.
We just confirmed that classic Loki is the main villain.
Oh.
Just kidding.
Oh.
But I think that's gonna be what happens since we just met him and he's got some backstory already built with the projections and being like
Why did I
super
do that
strong.
again? It definitely showed it as my phage. There you go. I fixed it.
Oh, you haven't seen it. Oh, well, you didn't really miss anything. You need to watch it anyway.
Spoiler alert.
Watch it. Anyway, you met him on, I think, on the end of one of the episodes before season five. He shows up. They talk a little bit about him, but I think this Loki is the bad guy. I wish you could see me pointing at my computer.
They can see you pointing at the computer if you show them,
I
but
think
they can't see what you're pointing
this
at.
guy here, this guy's the bad guy. I'm sure. I'm sure.
That was a good point. That was a good one. You could be like a makeup guru now with that kind of skill.
You, my buddy, who's 6'2", Lionel, just said he's only seen the first episode. Damn, you way behind.
Is that like first episode recently or first episode whenever it came out? Because that'll let me know what kind of person he is right now.
I don't know. Lionel's a he's a working man. He ain't got no time for shows. He's too busy playing some Warzone. He's waiting for me to get off this so we can game it up right now. He's ready to play some Warzone, get this dub, get dubs.
Dubs only, you heard?
Dubs only. You feel me? Fucking
Need a
idiot.
banana.
Need a banana in my hand.
No, just the peel, though.
Dubs
Just the
only.
peel.
Man, that is I every time that thing comes on my feed because I see it every day. I look
It's
at
because you click on it to make fun of it. You fucked yourself.
it. Oh man. I hate that. I don't even hate the guy. I hate his
You know
ad.
what? But his ad obviously worked, didn't it?
So I should make an ad that's just really obnoxious.
Hey, that's what worked for me the first time around.
What if Alligator
Ooh.
Loki was the main bad guy?
You know, that might make a little sense considering how lizardy those timekeepers looked. But he ain't got no thumbs. How would he have built them?
Shit, that'd be awesome if he was. What if it's a projection? What if
I mean,
Alligator
if
Loki
he's a
is a
Loki, he should
projection?
be able to like do kind of like wizardry, right? And magic.
Joel said he was hoping for Doctor Doom because it looks like his castle. But would it make sense that he's at the end of time unless he conquered a whole ass universe in a timeline?
That could be one of the timelines.
No, it's at the end of time or something like
It could
that.
be one of the timelines.
Yeah, I don't. Yeah, that doesn't make sense. I mean, I could see how
I'm just
they.
gonna try to encourage him. He needs encouragement.
I don't think it's definitely not that. I don't think it's Doctor Doom.
I don't think it's definitely
But
not
it's a
that.
good guess. It's a good guess.
Yes, I guess.
Buddy, it's a good guess. It's a very
It's
good
definitely a
guess.
guess.
It's like one of those like on the spot like I don't know what to think of kind of guess. You're just like, it could be Spider-Man's evil twin kind of guess. You know, it doesn't make
Definitely.
sense, but it was a guess. You know, maybe it's Spider-Man's evil twin.
Right.
He's in the MCU.
Totally.
Well, Liz, I don't know why you don't have any theories on this.
I don't have any logical theories, honestly. I mean, of course, I've let my imagination like sway. Like, wouldn't that be funny if, or wouldn't that be great if? But none of those theories I have in my head make a lot of sense. So let me just keep that stupidity to myself.
No, get the stupidity all out. Let it show like I do. My buddy Harry, he texted me. He said that Loki came out as a bisexual in this series, so there's that.
He also is, what is it called? Whenever you love yourself and not really anybody
Loki,
else.
Loki's a bisexual. I know he mentioned something about having relations with a horse. I don't know if
Yes,
anybody caught that.
that
He
was a
said
thing.
he fucked a horse. And I don't know if he was in the back or underneath. I try not to get a visual on it, but can't help it.
Autosexual. He's autosexual in the show too.
Joelle's hilarious. Joelle, that's not nice. You can't say stuff like that. He said, "Yeah, you stupid
I
women."
know he's right. I belong in the kitchen, definitely not in front of this camera.
You know what? In your
Barefoot and
defense,
pregnant.
you can cook. You can make
I
some
do believe that originally that was the only reason you kept me around, because I could cook chicken for you.
How is Black Widow, Joelle? Not Marvel's Loki, but the Greek mythology. What are you talking about, dude?
Where are we?
What are you talking about, dude? We're talking about Loki. Marvel's Loki.
Oh, this
I'm
got like
trying to.
real intense, like anti-Joelle real quick.
Oh, okay, cool. Nah, Joelle, it's never anti-Joelle. Joelle is the best. Joelle's a good friend of mine. Lives out of Austin. We
He
collect po
promised me
we collect
a few
Pokemon
game
cards.
matches with his new fight pad that never happened, so now I think that he's just a liar.
Joelle, are you a liar? We play Pokemon cards on the weekends.
Is he gonna really come play magic with y'all?
No, he's not.
Do he play?
Don't be saying that stuff. Shh.
If anybody plays magic, Joey's trying to get back into magic. He bought like 3,000 cards on eBay. So if you need a deck, he could probably make you one too.
I did buy some Magic the Gathering cards. Now, this is for educational purposes only. I don't play it on my free time. I just want to learn. I want to see what other people are doing. So I bought some so I can learn, because I don't find it fun at all. I don't do that.
Right.
I don't do that kind of stuff.
Let me let your friends know. I'll send them a link to this part of the video.
But if you are interested in buying some cards, some magic cards, eBay, for educational purposes, eBay has auctions for like $15 for like 500 cards.
How much
Stupid.
did you spend recently?
$15
What? You bought magic cards?
for educational purposes. I'm about to get
I am sending
dominated.
you a link, though, to the only theory that I really agreed with. Can you hear me?
Yeah, sure.
I'm sending you a
Whatever you
link to
say.
the only theory that I agreed with. I finally found it. I had to bring it up from my phone.
Joelle just said I was a sub. Guys, everybody watching my stream, Joelle, he's in my comment feed right now. If you're in the comment feeds, you
He's a
can
sub.
see everything that I'm responding to. Because you're like,
He is not a sub. Sorry, Joel. I'm gonna have to go ahead and clarify that.
if you want to know what I'm talking about, I'm just responding to my comments. Feel free to come talk in my comments so I could talk to you on here. If you got something intelligent to say, I'd love to hear it. Or
Even
something
if he's
dumb to
not
say, I would
intelligent.
definitely love to hear that.
So I sent you the only theory that I mostly agreed with, beginning to end.
Need to talk about the Infinity Stone theory for Loki.
It broke it down really, really well.
Is it worth pulling up? Is it worth me pulling
Yeah, I
up?
mean, it's worth you reading real quick. I don't know if it's worth you showing everybody else yet. Or you could just pull it on up in that browser page right there. Yep. Paste and go in the future.
Comment feed, bro. Yeah, you're on the comment feed right now. Comment feed. Yes, Lionel, comment feed. my 6'2" Mexican American friend. Hey man, I got a water pump that's going out. I need you to give me that podcast deal. Be on my podcast deal. Is there a such thing as a deal? Podcast deal?
I'm a celebrity deal.
Is there any celebrity deals? Do you do work for free for celebrities? Because if so, let me know.
I know one.
Because you kind of know somebody.
I'm a somebody.
I got some magic cards here. You want me to sign them and hand them to you? I'll do it.
You will, and nobody will come grab them.
Episode 1 has a connection to the Soul Stone. Episode 2 has a connection to the Reality Stone. Episode 3, connection to the Power Stone. Episode 4, Mind Stone. Episode 5, Time Stone. Okay, I'm not reading all this today.
Of course you're not.
But look at that picture,
Reading
man.
the card.
Who's this Loki over here? That's President Loki. And then we've got
Bicycle Loki.
Bicycle Loki? Ninja
Yeah,
Loki.
he's
They got Ninja
bicycle.
Loki. They got Ninja
There was
Loki.
homeless Loki.
Oh, look, there's another girl Loki over here with red
That is
hair.
not a girl. That's not a girl.
With red hair. Yes, it is. That's a
It's not
girl.
a girl.
That's an.
It's not a girl, I promise.
I'm
Did
gonna
you
look.
see the same episode? Oh, I'm gonna have to look up all the Lokis now.
What is if it? It's a lot of reading, man. There's like two paragraphs.
Well, that's why I sent it to you.
You know I can't do all that.
I know, I know, I know.
I have to read out loud. People don't want to
And
hear
you're
me
not
read
very
out
good
loud.
at doing it.
You heard me read out what the episode connections are. Yeah, see, he said he thought he saw a girl too. Look, Joel, I'm gonna
Not a
zoom it
girl, though.
up.
I'm sorry, guys.
Look, I'm gonna zoom it up. I'm gonna make this
I'm
bigger.
gonna pull
It
it up right now.
right there with the red hair. Is that another girl Loki? Is
And it's
that number
not
seven?
another girl, okay.
Dyslexic? Am I dyslexic?
You might be. I don't think you have dyscalculia, though, so just dyslexia.
Dyslexic? Hey, I only like women, bro.
Oh, I didn't mean to that. That was the wrong timing. My bad.
That's
Sorry.
pretty hilarious.
My bad.
Yeah, don't listen to Liz. She's oh.
I'm O. I don't think that's ever been a way you describe me.
Bad timing in that.
It was
Just
an
kidding.
accident.
I know, I'm just playing. Joel's just being mean.
My
Joel,
bully.
the comment
He's a
feed
bully.
troll.
He's kind of a bully, isn't he?
He's always mean. Joel's so mean. He's a meanie.
I'm not dumb.
Look, I'm gonna make the big camera on you for
Joel
you.
called me dumb.
Oh, that didn't
Joel
work.
called me dumb. That's the wrong fee. I don't feel dumb.
'Cause you're not dumb.
Joel called me dumb, though.
Joel's dumb.
Oh. Well, then that's why he's wrong.
Tell him about your degrees.
No. I'm not gonna flex.
Flex on his punk ass.
No. I was a child prodigy, and that is that.
Yeah, Joel. You know, like the band Prodigy,
Exactly like that,
but
yep.
with children.
Fire starter and everything.
I'm a fire starter, a children fire starter.
Whoa.
What? No, like a child who
Okay, but
starts.
like let's touch back on that one scene from American Gods where that guy was talking about eating little kids.
What? Man, I'm not gonna be able to find that in here.
Come on, the guy talking about eating little kids on American Gods. Was that not the strangest scene you've ever seen on television? Talking about how different kids taste different. If I had more room in my belly, I'd have eaten her little kid too.
Let's see if we can find something here for you. Nope.
I'm trying to find that redhead Loki so I can show y'all she's not a girl still. I'm committed to this. So the black Loki is boastful Loki.
Who?
Boastful Loki is the black Loki.
That's his name?
Boastful, yeah.
Oh, look, you know, we'll go back to American gods and we'll show the people media god.
So
Media.
cyclist Loki, bicycle Loki, by the way, he's the one that they credited to stealing the Tour de France trophy that went missing in 2018. It's a real world mystery, just like they gave him credit for DB Cooper.
Nice.
So the one that you're seeing that y'all think is female Loki, that is pansexual Loki.
The wrong button.
Pansexual Loki.
Guys, look at this scene here. Look how cool these guys are. These are the new gods right here. This guy right here, this is Technology Boy. They call him what do they call him? Tech Boy?
Tech boy, yeah. Techno boy.
Tech Boy. So he's the god of technology right here, this guy. And then he's about to talk to another god. He's being summoned by another god right now. And I think this god is probably one of the coolest ones. One of the coolest gods in the show.
He's definitely my favorite. Minus the whole lynching thing, that wasn't cool.
Oh, you pretty thing, you.
What?
You have an image problem.
This
you
is
your brand.
The god of media.
How you want Mr. World to see you. Tasked with asking a few questions, you hang a black man from a tree. You've got your transmission and your live wire, but your circuit's dead.
He was fucking with me. I told him not to fuck with me.
Take a look at you.
Anyway, I don't want to play too much because I'm just going to probably screw up my podcast and the audio just for playing that right there. But those are two gods and American gods going back to our initial topic. A scene from, I think that's like episode 3 or 2. Anyway, they're having a discussion about going to war with the old gods. So that's Techno Boy, which is the god of technology. And then this is the god of media right here. Media propaganda and news and all that stuff. And this person here, even though they look like David Bowie, they can actually transform into whoever they want. So they just use...
I mean, poorly. She just kind of does costume and makeup. She doesn't do what Mr. World does.
Yeah. She just uses like the different characters from TV shows. But it's pretty cool how they do it. I think it's definitely worth
I sent
investing
you some
some
fun
time.
Stuff that I thought might be interesting.
Oh, yeah. I'm not going to pull all that up.
Just read the titles on them. New window,
Loki,
new window. They don't have to be on your screen.
Loki,
window.
Loki's gender. Gen. What?
So the first one I sent you was the image from.
Gets his
Hold
first
on. So that one
major.
Loki that y'all said was a female. It's not a female. That is pansexual Loki.
That's pansexual Loki?
Mm-hmm.
And Loki gets his major queer character?
Is Loki's gender fluidity in Disney Plus series confirmed. And the next one, it was on Loki, the Marvel Cinematic Universe finally gets its first major queer character.
Well... Disney is really
queer.
Disney is really oh Disney sorry about that hit the wrong button Disney's moving forward with
they're being progressive as they can
hell yeah
which is cool
yeah
but like,
it's respectable
they, as long as they're not gonna like overgas it
yeah you know I don't really know how to feel about you know all of that like on a cartoon basis I guess it's whatever you know
I mean this is a directed show at adults I think
yeah true that well I think I can't talk about this show anymore. I have nothing else to add to it other than we already know Classic Loki.
Without entirely ruining the show for
you. You heard it here first. Classic Loki is the bad guy. I'm guessing it. I'm going to take a guess right now. Actually, I heard it first somewhere else. But you, the viewer, are hearing it first here. So you're going to be like, oh, yeah, he was right. He was fucking right, dude. Anything you want to add to that show?
Not. I don't want to overly spoil it. Hmm? It's a really good show. The cliffhangers that it has alone are worth every episode.
I mean, I don't think you're going to ruin anything.
I mean, there have been some people on this feed already that said that they hadn't seen it.
Yeah, and they left. Those bozos left. Just kidding. They're like my good friends.
Don't call your bozos.
They call me much worse. It's okay.
I'm sure.
Well, I think that's going to be the end of all our topics today. We're going to close that one out. Elizabeth, Dollface 1566 Gaming. Everybody add her page. If you haven't added, it's going to be in the comment section. Or the description, I'm sorry, for you to see it, add it. I appreciate everybody that showed up today. Next Thursday at 9 p.m. will be a new episode. I'll have another guest.
You better apologize to Lionel right here.
Lionel? Not me. Oh, I'm sorry, Lionel. I didn't mean for, give away some spoilers. Or I don't know what you're talking
about. That's not what he meant. He's talking about your friends that he's talking crap about over here.
Nah, I love Lionel. He's a good guy. He's one of the few good men. Anyway, we are going to end this stream, end this podcast. But before you do,
if you are watching from my channel and you don't already follow JRent2000, his link is in the description. So throw him a follow and a like as well.
Yeah, guys, I do gaming also. I haven't done it in a while because I've been working hard to put this episodes together for the podcast, so that way I can get on a schedule and do this. And hopefully you guys come join me every Thursday at 9 p.m. We'll probably be talking about aliens and UFOs on our next episode, so join us for that. That should be pretty fun. I think we'll have a lot of stuff. Trust me, I've seen aliens. I know they're real, and you will be exposed.
I mean, you also have my plug.
You will be exposed, aliens.
I don't believe in humans right here.
I love it.
Can't see it. I'm too short for my camera.
Oh, yeah. They do. They believe in us. They do. They believe in us. Anyways, thank you guys, everybody that's in the and still watching. Thank you for showing up. Liz, I'll see you later in a minute.
In a few seconds,
we'll see you later. All right, guys, we'll talk to you later.
Aliens.
Bye. Yeah. Bye. See you Thursday. Bye. Bye.